Pat, the country is mourning the loss of those U.S. forces killed over the weekend in Afghanistan. We're now hearing from family members and learning more about the men who sacrificed so much. Mark Martin has that story.
It's the deadliest single day for U.S. forces in the decade-long war in Afghanistan. A Chinook helicopter carrying 30 Americans shot down. Everyone died, including 22 Navy SEALs. Most of them part of the covert SEAL Team 6, the elite unit who killed Osama bin Laden in May. None of the men who took part in that raid were believed to be on the helicopter.
This elite team of SEALs is stationed here in Virginia Beach at the base behind me down this road. This tight-knit Navy community is feeling the loss. To them, these SEAL casualties are so much more than headlines or statistics. They are neighbors, husbands, and fathers.
They're warriors when they're at work, but they have children. They're daddy. You know, they're somebody's husband.
Diane Shipley and her retired Navy SEAL husband, Don, are part of the close SEAL community here. News of the tragedy spread fast.
I got a phone call from one of the wives, and I immediately screamed and started naming off names to make sure that immediate family was safe, and then we just cried.
Members of SEAL Team 6 are the best of the best. Losing so many at one time is a devastating blow.
It's important to understand what these guys do over there. They're Spartans. They're gladiators.
One of those gladiators was 25-year-old Petty Officer Michael Strange.
He said he'd be home for Thanksgiving. He was a great kid, man. He fought for this country.
Then there's 30-year-old Aaron Carson Vaughn, a father of two, with a newborn on the way.
He was a fabulous son to his parents and a great big brother. And to me, he was the love of my life.
But I want us as a church to ask the God of all comfort to be with these families.
Churches in Virginia Beach spent Sunday ministering and praying for families who lost loved ones.
We'll just be there as a church. They need food. They need us to take care of their kids.
It's a community coming together to help each other heal from tragedy.
And to see the sacrifice our families make and then this further sacrifice just hurts. It hurts us all. It shocks us all. And because we're going to miss them terribly.
Mark Martin, CBN News.
For these families.
You know, Lee, many of the SEALs from SEAL Team 6, I mean, not many, a number of them, worked here at CBN in our security department. They're absolutely marvelous people. And as they said, the best of the best. They're warriors, gladiators. They're willing to die for this country. But I want everybody to think about Afghanistan. I was over there years ago on the border of Afghanistan when the Russians had come in. The Russians turned tail and left. They couldn't subdue that country. It is perhaps the largest exporter of heroin in the world, the opium poppies. It is terribly corrupt. Bribery is endemic. The president is corrupt. His family is corrupt. The warlords are corrupt. The whole place stinks. Why should we have brilliant Navy SEALs dying in the mountains of Afghanistan? I think the time has come to say, look, this has been interesting, but we're out of here. I know this. Some people say, well, you're defeatist, you're getting to be isolationist. I don't think it's isolationist to not want to waste our people's lives and our treasure in that godforsaken mountainous area that's led by a bunch of crooks. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. Why should we do it? I mean, it's not that strategic. People think it is, but it's not. And it is impassable. Mountains over there. If you've been to Peshawar in Pakistan, I've been on the border and these other places and talked to the Mujahideen years ago. I mean, they're fighters, they're killers, and they're warlords. Why waste those wonderful young men in our SEAL team or any other unit of the United States military in that hellhole? Lee,